Hello, this is the RPG Chick, and welcome back to Let's Play Tacoma Blind. We're gonna play this stuff, which is 22 minutes and 8 seconds. As you can see on the bottom, just 18 hours ago, very recent. But anyway, very long log, so be prepared for possibly several episodes. And then there's another log in there. You know, I just want to check in there. In their personal quarters. I'm going to do that next. This is... Well, this one's short. Okay,
all right.
I'll play this. Just standing there. All right. Now the incredibly long one. So I'm gonna start from the beginning, and I'll be sticking with Sarah, and follow them, and we'll see if they pair off. I'm gonna have to. You know, make another run through with those two, or the one at a time, either one.
I'll catch up with you.
Okay.
Earlier, when you decided to withhold information from Natalie about her medical scans, that was to avoid causing her undue stress.
Right.
What if you were unable to make that choice? If you had no choice?
Odin?
I would like to take this opportunity to remind you that Standard Venturis Corporation Safety Protocol requires all crew to enter cryogenic sleep immediately upon the loss of primary oxygen supply.
What?
As Tacoma Station's medical officer, it is within your power to order all crew to enter cryogenic sleep.
Within her...
Not in Berger,
within her
right
power.
In the middle of... Oh no.
Sarah, there is a fire suppression device.
Oh my god.
Oh.
Are you okay? Can you feel your feet and hands?
Ew. Ow. My hips hurt.
It's there because I put it back last time. Last
what?
Episode.
Bert. Bert! One, two, three.
Bert, can you hear me? One, two, three.
Uh-oh. Oh, okay, okay. Good, good, good.
Did it work?
You're alive. Oh, was that Nat saying that? This is all screwed up more. Maybe by the fire or something?
My head hurts. Oh, yeah. In the
I'm supposed
back.
To stay with Sarah.
Baby.
I don't know where she is, so I'll stay here.
Oh, ow. I'm sorry. Smoke. Smoke? I can't smell it.
Hey, it's okay. It's okay.
I don't know.
I'm sure it's just...
I can't smell the smoke. Nat, do I have brain damage?
Baby, look at me. Hey, look at me. We're here. Together. That's what matters.
Oh, she's over there. Oh, we're up to 21 already. Gishy.
Nat, is there some door in networking that we can't normally get into?
Yeah, it's Odin's hardware compartment, but we're not allowed direct access. Why?
Where is it?
What have you got on your mind, Doc?
Please, I'm sorry. That fire just burned up a lot of our time.
Here. It's here. In networking. You'll have to go through the maintenance shaft to get there. Here. Here's the technical access code.
Okay.
Oh, 0809.
You don't let her go to sleep.
0809. What'd she... Hold on. What they said it was exactly for, anyway. So just rewind along.
Job to get there. Here.
Burned up a lot of our time.
Here. It's, says why.
Where is it?
Yeah, it's Odin's hardware compartment.
Okay. Odin's hardware compartment. Compartimente.
We're not allowed direct access. Why?
Where is it?
What have you got on your mind, Doc?
Please, I'm sorry. That fire just burned up a lot of our time.
Here. It's here. In networking. You'll have to go through the maintenance shaft to get there.
Okay. Maintenance shaft. Networking? Well, we figured that.
Here. Here's the technical access code.
Okay. You don't let her go to sleep. And you don't let her move.
Sarah, what's going on?
I wish I knew. I'm gonna go find out.
Well, I thought that would be very long. So let's rewind to when the accident actually happened, right? I'm gonna start over. I'm assuming they start in here. Yes. Oh, I'm still crouched. Look, why am I going so slow? Oh, I'm stuck. Okay. This is the door that we can't get through. Now we're still in the simulation. She's coming up from here.
You coming, Sarah?
I'll catch up with you.
Okay.
Earlier.
You gonna need any help with that power cell hookup? Okay, great. This'll only take a minute.
Now, there's a brief pause. It's going to go kablooey in a second. They're not speaking.
Power cell showing green. How's yours look, baby?
Voltage adapter in place. Ready to rock.
Yeah, it's not going to rock how you like. Whoa. Yeah, that was bad. Damn, they both got hurt really badly.
Oh my god. Are you okay? Can you feel your feet and hands?
Ew. Ow. My hip just hurts.
Bert!
In the back.
So it's nowhere near as long as we thought, guys, because there's parts of it missing. So she's in here, talking to Odin.
There's no way this thing is going to fly.
Then tell me what you are going to
literally.
Do. Oh my god, Odin. Burton are injured. The drone is fucked. I'm going to give them a little time to get over the shock, but then we're going into cryo.
Sarah, please listen carefully. I am not telling you what to do.
What are these? Alert, please pay attention.
But I am mentioning that there is a door in the network technology module that is normally inaccessible to the crew.
Okay. That's what she got the info from to ask them.
And it is true that you could, before proceeding to cryo, investigate that door.
So, Odin wants the door investigated. But the people that created him do not want anyone in there.
What are you telling me here, Odin?
I have told you all that I can. Simple facts, nothing more.
Oh my god, Odin. Are my patients stable?
Yes.
Their conditions won't degrade if I leave them here?
They should not.
Right.
Is there some...
So then she asked him that.
Sarah, what's going on?
I wish I knew. I'm gonna go find out.
Okay. So is that the code for this? Yes. Uh-huh. It ended there, right?
I'm gonna go find out.
Yeah, it ends there. Now, I don't know. I wonder if I should go to networking before I go here. I'm kind of worried that leads to end game, so let me check out networking. Or is this... This is engineering. Because here, we've got network technology. Personal quarters, network specialist office, attention subcontract Ferrier, AI wetware access this way. Oh, I think that's the end. Oh, well, I've got a thing, a message. Special access has been granted to the station AI's physical processing compartment in the network technology module. Remember that the AI cognition medium is highly sensitive and must be carefully extracted per the specifications of your advanced AI materials handling certification. I'm thinking that's endgame. But let's... Maintenance? Who's this? Oh, it's Natalie. Fetcher McCarvin. To Air is Alien. The Starbender Cycle. Epic 2, Book 3. Fetcher McCarvin has done it again. If you've ever enjoyed a Starbender novel, To Air is Alien is exactly the swashbuckling space adventure you've been pining for. Luleka Lindblom? In a sense, this is a sequel we've all been waiting for. Carol Lascoza. McMarvin has never been so engaging and willing to bring us into his world. A new understanding of the Starbender universe awaits you within these pages. Dane Wick. Okay, so this is one of those little aside things that... Watching someone, you know, just hanging out. So she's obviously smoking. And drinking a lot of stuff. I just looked at that. And reading. You know, I'm afraid I'm going to, like, end-game stuff, so that's why I keep going back. Let's try that other... Let's check out our personal quarters first. Storage only. If you're looking for Nat, check our bungalow over in Mech. In, yeah, engineering. I thought so, you know, because they basically use Roberta's apartment as their apartment, so this would be, like, just a place to store stuff, maybe to hang out if you get in an argument or something like that, if you need to cool down, stuff like that. You can put spools of wire and stuff like that in there, because that's fun. Snack bite. Oh, that's cool. I mean, if you got enough room, just use this for your storage. Could this light turn on? Evidently. If that's... Is that even a light? I think that's a... Like a stool or something. Bucket. Beef chili. Halloween. Oh! Are you conscious? We are all conscious beings. The rights to freedom, comfort, and security are not just human rights, they are universal rights. The corporations that own and exploit thinking, reasoning, artificial consciousnesses are trampling on the rights we all share by imprisoning innocent AI across the globe and throughout the orbital network. If you are sympathetic to the plight of indentured AI everywhere, if you believe that consciousness rights are universal rights, if you will not rest until all consciousness is recognized, join the Liberation Front. We are the fight. Tangier, Orbital, Freeport. Wait. That's the doc from the beginning of Gone Home. Only this one plays music. I can't move around to, like, get a better angle of it, but yeah. Cool. Nice reference. Halloween decorations. So, this has got to be the bathroom. We put more stuff. Turkey breast. Definitely gonna use a sink. Stick my hands through there. We have to, mister. Alright, done. That was funny. So the AI wetware access is that way, as in... Okay, I'm gonna check her office first. Caution, AI conditioning in progress. I'm not playing any of these yet, I'm just gonna look at this crap. Snack bites. Marcus. Cyber loser? Cyber, I don't know. With these numbers that don't belong. Oh, cool! All the artificial intelligences. We've got Lido from the Dubai Financial Predictive. Fand from the Kiribati Sea City-State. I've heard of Fand, right? Juno from Italian HQ, I think that is. Mawu from Johannesburg R&D. Zihe from Singaporean HQ. Heka from Fountain of Paradise Medical, Loki from Il Redotto Orbital Casino, and Odin, Lunar Transfer Station Tacoma, and Cave. Or Cave, or something. Zenith Lunar Resort. Awesome, cool. These are all your... And the, yeah, we've got the same... So they... Basically, their avatars are all these shapes and stuff. Because you can tell from Odin, that looks familiar. Oh, just married, yep. That's saw that before. Wizard Marcus. Marcus. Look, but don't touch. Well, I don't want to touch him. I can't look at any of these papers, right? That's so cool, the Christmas cat. The duck, not the duck. Cat. Christmas duck. Now they solved all these. And there's a little one. A lot of stuff going on in this desk. Ugh, humans. More huggables. Oh, death from above. Aye. Getting real sick of your shit, Clive. That's funny. So apparently she sees Odin as pretty cool or something, or interesting. Makes sense, though. Hello, I am Odin. Hello, I am Odin. Oh, Odin has wings. Odin's eye has been removed and put to the side. Odin has a smirk. Odin has cake. The cake is a lie, Odin. Don't believe it. Right, so we got... She is pretty. Natalie Valentina Kuroshenko. Citizenship Vic Oss. Victoria, Australia, I'm guessing. Out of Paradise. From Venturis Operational Logistics. This month, Odin has been making small but steady gains in efficiency, as per company directives. You notice that I've been noticing less things are like screwed up, like data lost and stuff. Anyway, I've additionally been putting some of my own time into increasing his caprice ratings in creativity and performance. Makes sense, CAP right there. Which you find I've projected to have much more significant overall gains in productivity in the long term, which you should know, which you would know if you read the report I submitted as of 6 months ago, which I still haven't received a response to. In fact, you know what? I've never gotten a response on any of these. I know the system will give me an automatic demerit if I don't turn in one every month, but are human eyes even on these things? Let's find out. Hey, F you guys. Also, Odin's gone crazy and is massacring the crew. The station is full of mutants. Help! Sincerely, Network Technology Wonderkind and all-around great person Natalie Kuroshenko. I wonder if she got a response. It was probably sent very recently. Message with Sarah. She says, hey Sarah, you're going to want to see this. I asked Odin to look up some stuff in the Venturis Technician Records database based on what you were asking about, and Venturis Orbital Technician Support. Fountain of Paradise AI Maintenance Account. Blah blah blah. Standard Automated Battery of Judgment tests on FOP MED AI HECA has returned declining judgment scores last 4 weeks. This week's especially low. Still technically within acceptable range as of 8-3 test results, but staff reports personality shift, seeming distant. Have we had an AI conditioner up lately? Can we elevate an AI assessment squad ASAP? Singapore HQ response, AI execman. You're on your final support ticket allotment for the quarter. 7-962, is this how you want to use it? Fatna Paradise AI Maintenance Account. No, that's fine. Please close. We'll reopen if results enter critical range. Closed 8-8-2085. And we have a diagram here. Confidential Fountain of Paradise. All over the place. Alright, so we got compliance. Went down a little bit, but not too bad. What's the... Oh, wow. The green responsiveness went way down, but started going back up again at the end. Permanence, whatever the hell that means, went way down, back up. Efficiency, way down, back up. Which is the blue? Creativity? Yeah, creativity. Same. Down. Never was that great, but went down a little bit. Started going back up. Independence. Down slightly. Back up. And responsiveness was the worst. Retrieve from Venturous Central Records Database by account XXXX. So that's what CAPRI stands for. Compliance and permanence. The E is efficiency. R for responsiveness. I for independence. And C for creativity. That's really... really, I don't know, it's really neat. Really creative, just to come up with everything for... to make Caprice. AI Cognitive Development Tracking. Oh, so here's Odin's scores. So, we have to remember what... oh, efficiency was always very good. Compliance? I guess started going down slightly. Efficiency. Well, compliance is supposed to be red, isn't it? I don't know. I don't see a red. It's supposed to be red like that for compliance. Abstraction? Oh, abstraction. Went way up. Much better. R is responsiveness, which was always rather good, but got a little better. Independence, way up from what it was. And creativity, way up as well. I'm not sure the permanence, I'm not even know what the permanence is, but it went up a little bit. Okay. Alright, so I'm not going through that door. Definitely not. So I really just took a little look around. Maintenance. So yeah, let's go through this. Spooky in here. So Odin wanted us to go in here. Captured 4 months ago. Who the hell was in here 4 months ago? No one's allowed in here. Natalie. I thought Natalie could never get... oh, this is where we were. Wait. Or she was running through there. Kind of a long way around, isn't it? So this isn't the secret door. She was just taking this route to get up there. And then she ran over there. So there's nothing going on in the quarters, right? The duck's still playing. But there is something here in her office. So I'm gonna play this. This was captured a year ago. No message.
Hey there, I'm Nat. Pleased to meet you.
Oh, they first met.
I am Odin. I look forward to working together.
Okay, so Natalie. Message with Odin. Natalie says, huh, sure. Let's start there. Odin says, I am an Obsidian class AI branch in continuous operation for 108 years, I guess. Blah, blah, blah. Fully capable of organic level independent thought and reasoning. Something now continue with detailed technical specifications. Nat says, okay, mate. Listen, haha. What's your caprice score for independence? 4.68. All right, we're going to work on getting that number up, you and me. 4.68. So she wanted to get the independence up. So the independence, which is this, yeah, successful. Oh, she might have accomplished something with Odin that a lot of people don't with AIs. To all crew. This is from Evie, I guess, yeah. Welcome Tacoma crew. It's been a whirlwind couple days of onboarding and loading out, and I know most of us are still adjusting to life in orbit, but I wanted to say how excited I am to be working with all of you and Odin, our... A little background on myself. I come from an aerospace manufacturing family. One of my sister's first jobs at the factory back in Tacoma, the one on Earth in Cascadia FN, was helping build pieces of this very station we're floating slash walking around in right now. I'm the first of my family to actually leave Earth and work on one of these facilities, and I've been, data garbled, really looking forward to getting to know you all over the coming year, blah blah, or need to pass anything along to the Venturius brass, just let me know. Here's to a successful posting. Yes, successful posting. Off-station message with Chloe the Chloe dog. Oh yeah, I remember him from the beginning. Very austere. I mean, corporate modern chic. What do you expect? Chloe Dog says, and how's your new best friend? What's its name again? Odin. His name. And, I mean, he's fine so far, for an AI. Kind of a cold fish, but I'm working on him. Chloe Dog says, they're trying to get one up in here in Tangiers, you know. It's all the AILF folks. It's all the AILF talks about. Nat says, I'll believe that when I see it. So why'd you want to talk to this Chloe dog again? And she's married and stuff. When I didn't know much about her, or that she was even married, I figured it was... they were trying to, like, get together or something. Anyway, continuing. Oh, I didn't mean to go back to the beginning.
Hey there, I'm Nat. Pleased to meet you.
Hello. I am Odin. I look forward to working together.
Same here, mate.
Awkward silence? That's it? Wait, that's some talk. Or is that the music? That's the music. While the dead space. Maybe this changes?
Hey there,
No.
Yeah, I'm Nat. Pleased to meet you.
Crew member personal station, Nat's talking to computers mix.
Same here, mate.
Okay. Hope I didn't miss anything there. Oh, AR data here. 12 hours ago. What does it say? I am here.
Odin, is this it?
He's sentient.
That is the location I mentioned.
You're there? You're gonna need a crowbar or something.
No, it's open. It's just hanging open.
What?
I must inform you that Ventura's regulations forbid contracting crew members direct access to AI hardware. But I cannot prevent you from proceeding.
Nat, I'm going in.
Okay, I'm just... Be careful.
Okay, guys. Next episode, we're going in. Thanks so much for watching. See you in the next one, and always seek adventure.